Hey guys, what's up? It's Techosaur here. Today I've got my hands on the WD Black SN770M, which is Gen 4 SSD. And it's also rated at a read speed of 5150MB. So in this video, I'll guide you through the installation process step by step, as well as my way of installing Windows 11 without the need to use ASUS Cloud Recovery or Rufus. I'll also benchmark it against the stock SSD. So now let's remove the old SSD, and always remember to disconnect the battery cable. So currently I've got this copper heatsink, which is being commonly used for this handhelds. But honestly saying, I didn't feel much of a time difference, so I'll be upgrading to a better one pretty soon. And of course I'll share that with you all here, including also a comparison against this current one. So stay tuned. I also have this 1.5mm thermal pad by Arctic. Let's do some measures. Cut and stick it. And with everything ready, let's install the SSD and reconnect the battery cable. Moving on to the Windows 11 installation process. Simply search for download Windows 11 and install the Windows 11 image creation tool by Microsoft themselves. It can create you an image of Windows 11 latest version onto a USB drive. Connect the drive to your Ally. By default, with an empty SSD, it should automatically boot to the USB drive instead. Another thing I'd like to mention, that during the Windows installation, you might hit the wall with network connectivity issues, but no worries. Download the Wi-Fi driver from the Ally support page. Copy it to a USB drive, and while you are in the network window, press Shift and F10 on your keyboard. This will open the command prompt. Here enter explorer.exe, and as you can see, you can access the USB drive in this way and install the Wi-Fi driver. It's as easy as that. With Windows up and running, we can now install WD dashboard software. And with it, you can monitor the stats of your SSD, check drive health, as well as capacity and temperature. Also in tools, you can update the firmware of the SSD, so make sure to check for updates from time to time. Down here, you can activate the trim feature in order to remove unused Windows files to save storage. You can toggle it to activate automatically once a week. So now everything is prepared. Let's do a crystal disk benchmark to see the difference of speed. As the results show, the difference is quite substantial. We are talking about a 1000MB increase in read speed and a jump from 1700 to 4700MB in write speed. That's really impressive, but let's see how this will translate in games loadings. When it comes to game loading times, both the Micron and the SN770M being a Gen4, there isn't any notable difference. However, spec-wise and in practical usage outside gaming, the WD770M is undeniably more powerful. So if you are looking for a top-tier SSD for your Ally, I really hope this video brought value to you. If so, please subscribe to support me and to stay updated on all Ally content. And remember, there is an exciting SSD heatsink upgrade coming soon, so don't miss it out. Until next time, take care.